We are delighted that you've joined us for today's episode of Piping Up, Organ Concerts at Temple Square. This show is presented by the Tabernacle Choir at Temple Square and streams every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time on the website you're watching right now. You can access downloadable programs for this week's performances of Piping Up and for all previous episodes at tabchoir.org/pipingup. Today's featured performer is Principal Tabernacle Organist Richard Elliott, and in commemoration of Independence Day in the United States, he has chosen a program filled with Americana, organ music by mostly American composers on American themes and celebrating the best of American values. He starts off with his own arrangement of Columbia, the Gem of the Ocean, a song that for nearly two centuries has been one of the unofficial national anthems of this country. Eugene Thayer is not a name most people are familiar with, though some might have heard of his good friend and fellow organist, Dudley Buck. Thayer studied with Karl Haupt in Berlin in 1865, and after a concert tour of Germany the following year, returned to the United States and worked as an organist in Boston and New York. He published mostly organ works, including five organ sonatas. We'll hear next his Fugue on America, from the organ sonata number 2, composed and published while Thayer was in Germany. You have joined us for Piping Up, organ concerts at Temple Square, with our featured organist today, Richard Elliott. These concerts are streamed every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time, right here, where you're watching us now. At the height of his European fame, Antonin Dvorak was invited to the United States. He spent 3 years in the 1890s as director of the National Conservatory in New York. There, he befriended the African-American musician Harry Burley, who was an expert on spirituals. It was Burley's rich, warm singing voice and the affecting quality of the spiritual that inspired Dvorak to write the Largo movement from his New World Symphony. We'll hear that work now in an organ transcription by the American organist and music editor Henry Clough Leiter.
Thank you.
We've just heard Richard Elliott perform the March from Three Impressions by former Tabernacle organist Robert Cundick. Keeping up the tradition at these noon concerts, we'll hear now the organist's own arrangement of the Latter-day Saint hymn, Come, Come Ye Saints, followed by an old melody. Today, that old melody is Shenandoah, an American folk song from the early 19th century that became especially popular among the flatboatmen of the Mississippi and Missouri River valleys later in the century.
Thank you.
The final work on today's Independence Day edition of Piping Up is the song Every Time I Feel the Spirit. Like the Largo from Dvorak's New World Symphony, which we heard earlier, this work connects deeply to the defining traditions of the African-American spiritual. In fact, Harry Burley, Dvorak's friend and associate, also sang and published one of the first arrangements of Every Time I Feel the Spirit in 1925. The words of this spiritual, like so many others, speak of a longing for freedom and a determination to trust in God no matter how difficult the present circumstances. And this is particularly relevant to a celebration of Independence Day. The Declaration of Independence was not a declaration of victory or of an achievement already obtained. The battle was still ahead. It was a statement of ideals, of principles, the firm belief that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by God with unalienable rights, including life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And these are exactly the ideals and aspirations expressed in African American spirituals, so many of which date from well after 1776. This annual celebration then helps us all remember that the values on which this country was founded and to which it has aspired ever since, have not yet been fully achieved, not for everyone. So much of the battle is still ahead, and it will be only won with love. The light of liberty and true freedom is the light of love, the pure love of Christ, that urges us to help and support our neighbors as they also strive for liberty and happiness. As John the Evangelist wrote, "He that saith he is in the light and hateth his brother is in darkness even until now. He that loveth his brother abideth in the light." We'll hear now Richard Elliott's own arrangement of the African American spiritual, Every Time I Feel the Spirit.
Thank you.
hope you've enjoyed this presentation of Piping Up with Richard Elliott, performing on the historic Tabernacle organ in Salt Lake City. And you are welcome to join us again for more inspiring organ music from Piping Up, streamed every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Mountain Time on the Tabernacle Choir's website and YouTube channel and on broadcasts.churchofjesuschrist.org.